Okay. Kaleigh Kurtz with us after the 1-1 draw with Chicago. KK, from your center back spot, obviously a lot went on in this one. Kind of just take us through from the player perspective kind of what this game was like for you guys to be out there.
It was different. Because we weren't really able to play the style that we want, it wasn't as fun as some of the other games that we played in, to be, like, truth be told, and you know me, I'm very blunt about what I say. So, it wasn't the most fun because we weren't able to dictate the play and possession quite like we wanted to. We had to completely change our press, and we had worked really hard all week on really solidifying that with everyone coming back in, figuring out, you know, the best style that worked for us based on the personnel. And so just having a man down kind of early was challenging. We had to change things up, but it also gave us an opportunity to, you know, see how it goes, because the ball is round. Anything can happen in any given week. We could be down to 10 players next week. Knock on wood. I hope that doesn't happen, but we have to be ready to change tactics at a moment's notice, and I think we did a pretty good job with that, considering giving up a goal on a set piece is, you know, unfortunate, but when you look at our typical average size on our team, it's not the tallest of squads, so sometimes that's going to happen. It's slightly lapse of concentration for 10 seconds, but in run of play, we did a really good job of, you know, getting our body on the line, blocking shots, doing what we needed to do.
You only had 15 minutes to see it, but it seemed like when you guys were full staffed, it seemed like things were looking really, really good for you. How did it feel to just kind of have the full shift back for the first time, even though you didn't get to kind of play out a full 90 like you would have wanted to?
It felt pretty good. We needed, obviously it was a hot day, so we had to kind of settle into the game a little bit. We knew that we're probably a little more used to this heat and humidity than Chicago, so that was one of the pluses, but typically with our style of play, we really like to dictate the play and have the ball and have possession. So then when we were just trying to, like, I guess, regain those connections that we had maybe lost in those relationships. So regain those connections with the personnel that we maybe haven't played next to in a couple weeks. And then Manaka's new, and she's one. I mean, she's a phenomenal player. She's amazing. It's going to be so fun to watch when we're 11v11. I think she got into great pockets, great spaces. She's an energizer bunny. And she just came into this heat like it was nothing. So I'm really excited to continue to play with her as the 10 and see how she keeps evolving and how we keep evolving with her.
Turn it over to questions in the room.
Marcy, you've got the support for Jenny on your wrist. From your point of view, what are the things that we all, just as an entire soccer body of fans and officials, need to start doing to really push the needle on systemic change?
One, I think, believe the players. If they feel like they are in a situation that makes them feel uncomfortable, typically we're not just going to say that. It's probably because we felt uncomfortable. And yes, sometimes it's not like someone doing it on purpose, but there are times where people are in a position of power that, you know, maybe they do take advantage. So one, understanding and like realizing that, you know, we are players and it takes a lot of courage to stand up. So backing those players, I think, is one of the biggest things, and then not letting the story die down. Like, keep pressing and just continue to show support. Like, I think if it was me and I was that player, having just even us showing a little support with a wristband just shows that we're behind you and we hear you, and, you know, like, whatever we can do, we're here, we're gonna listen. But it's her story, so all we can really do is, you know, back that story and not change it. It's, I'm here to support you.
What'd you think of the weather delay?
Weird rule. For me, oh gosh, I hope this doesn't get me in trouble, but for me, like, it's almost worse to stop 30 minutes in, get cooled down for 10 minutes, and then have to do another 10-minute warm-up. And then now I actually have more meters under my legs because I have the same amount of time that I have to play, but now I have a second warm-up. So I didn't like it. I think if, like, this happens again and you guys really want to, you know, like, protect us, give us an extra water break, if that's what it is. Like, do what we did in Portland when there was wildfires and the air quality wasn't as good. But to have us cool our legs down to then have to re-warm up, put more meters on it than typical, and then when we're already down to 10 men, 10 women, it's like, what? So it wasn't my favorite thing I've ever done, but, you know, like, it's not my rule, and I just have to off of it. But for me, I thought it was kind of hard on my legs to get moving again.
Any other questions in the room?
Good.
Great. Thanks, KK.
Thank you.
Hey.